Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Unmal. In this video, we will see example of spatial domain filtering. So this is the problem that we want to solve. We have been provided with a 3-bit 4x4 image and we want to perform the operation of simple averaging, weighted averaging, median filtering and Laplacian filtering on this image. And we have to use a mask size of 3x3 in all the cases. Also, they have clearly specified that we should use pixel replication at the boundary. So, whenever we perform any spatial domain filtering operation, it's a 3-step process that we need to perform. In step 1, we need to extend the image at the boundary based on the mask that has been provided. In the second step, we extract the sub-images. And then, in the next step, we perform the operation of spatial domain filtering. So, let's perform these steps one by one now. So, first step is pixel replication at the boundary. So, we have been provided a mask of 3x3 size. So, we need to identify how much padding we need to do. So, in this case, the padding will be mask minus 1 divided by 2. So, my mask size is 3. Minus 1 divided by 2, I will get the value as 1. This means that I need to pad my image with one row and one column on each side. So that is what we have done over here. So these are my padded portions shown with the green color. And the value is replicated. That means this 4 is replicated over here. This 6 is replicated over here. 0 is replicated over here. 5 is replicated over here and so on. In the next step, we need to identify or the extract the sub-images. Now, whenever we do a spatial domain filtering, we will always ensure that we keep the center of the mask inside the image only. This will ensure that my input image size and output image size is same. So, when we keep my center at the first pixel of my original image, this is the underneath sub-image what I will have. So, that is what has been shown over here. Now, in the next step, I will move the center to the next pixel. So, that is what the underneath sub-image I will get. So, this is shown over here. So, like this, we can put our center over here and so on. So, there are 16 pixels in the image. So, we will get the 16 different sub-images. Now, we have the third step where we perform the actual filter. So, what we do? Okay. Whenever we have a spatial domain filtering, we take the mask, we take the underneath sub-image, we multiply them point by point and sum it up together. And whatever the result that we have, that we put back where my center lies. Now let's consider the first case where we have the simple averaging to be performed. And this is the corresponding mask. So if you observe the mask carefully, it is all ones with a multiplying factor of 1 by 9. It means that each pixel will have a weight of 1 by 9 over here. So what we do, we take this mask and the corresponding sub-image, we multiply them point by point, we sum it up together, okay. So over here it is 1 by 9 multiplied by 4 plus 1 by 9 multiplied by 4 plus 1 by 9 multiplied by 6 plus 1 by 9 multiplied by 4 and so on. So when you find it, you will get that result as 4.89. So this will be our result where this particular pixel was lying in my original image. Like this, we'll perform the operation for each pixel. That means for each sub-image, I multiply my mass point by point, sum it up together and get the result. And those values will then be put in the output image. So if we do that, we will get a result something like this. So for 16 different sub-images, I will get 16 different results. Okay. So these are my 4x4 output image after simple averaging. But now if you observe carefully, you will find that the values are not exactly integer. Whereas, my input image or my problem statement clearly specified that my image is a 3-bit. It means that I will have the values in the range of 0 to 7 and the values will be integer. Okay? So, if you observe carefully, as I said, it is not integer. So, what we need to do is simply round them off to convert them to valid integer values. Okay. So after rounding off, this is what my final result will be. So this is my final result of simple averaging. Same process we can now carry out with weighted averaging. Now my mask is slightly different. So over here, if you observe, the weights are 1, 2, 1, 2, 4, 2, 1, 2, 1 with a multiplying factor of 1 by 16 over here. That means this pixel is going to have a weight of 1 by 16. This pixel is going to have a weight of 2 by 16 and so on. Or in simple words, all my diagonal neighbors have a weight of 1 by 16. All my four neighbors have a weight of 2 by 16. And my center pixel has a weight of 4 by 16. So again, same story. Take the mass, multiply it by point with the sum images, sum it up together. So over here it will be 1 by 16 multiplied by 4 plus 2 by 16 multiplied by 4 plus 1 by 16 multiplied by 6 plus 2 by 16 multiplied by 4 plus 4 by 16 multiplied by 4 and so on. So this is how it will look like, and this is what the final result I will get. That is 4.69. And again repeat the process for each and every pixel. That means multiply it with all the 16 sub-images, sum it up together, get the result. And this is what the final result of the weighted averaging will be. Again, values are not integer, so we will round them off and we will convert them to the valid integer values. Now let's go for the third case. So in the third case, we have median phasing. Now, median filtering is a class of order statistics filters. So, in this case, actually we don't have any mask as such. But what we have is only sub-images of the size of mask. Okay. So, over here it is a 3x3. So, my sub-image is also of the size of 3x3. So, what we do over here, for any order statistic filter, we first take the sub-image and then we order the elements of that sub-image either in the ascending order or in the descending order. Okay. So over here I have gone for a ascending order. Okay. Now if I want to perform an operation of mean filter, that is minimum. So I will take the first value of this ordered array. If I want to perform a max filter, I will take the last value. If I want to perform a midpoint filter, then I will take the average of the first and the last value, that is 4 plus 6 divided by 2. In case of median filter, now we can find out the median term of this ordered array. This is a 3x3 image, that means it has total 9 elements. So when I have ordered elements, total 9 elements will be there. So center will be the 5th element. So I have 4 elements on the left and 4 elements on the right. Okay. So this 5th element is at the center, and that is what my median term is. So my output of the median filtering will be 5 for this particular sub-image. Same operation again I will do for all the sub-images, and this is what the result I will get. And obviously in this case I get my results directly integer. Now for the last case, okay, before that, yeah. So in this particular case, now this is my input image. Actually if you observe carefully, okay, this upper region has the higher values, and this lower region of the input image has less value. So upper values are bright, but in that case you can see a value 0, that is actually a black pixel. And in the lower values which are dark, actually you can see a 7, that will be a white pixel. So there is kind of a salt and pepper noise present in this image. And if you can observe the output, okay, that salt and pepper noise is actually eliminated using this median filter. Now coming to the last case where we want to apply the Laplacian filter. Now in this particular case, as you all aware, we have four different masks for a Laplacian filter. Okay. We have either mask with positive center or a negative center, and also we have mask either with four neighbors or eight neighbors. So let's say I go for a four neighbors. Okay. And I go for a mask with positive center. That means my center over here is 4. And my four neighbors are minus 1. If I go for a negative center, then this would have been minus 4. And these four neighbors would have been 1. Okay. And of course, the diagonal neighbors are 0. Now, for this particular case, again, I will do the same process. I will multiply the mass point by point with my sub-image, sum it up together, and whatever result I get, we will put it back to the center where my center of the mass was lying. Okay. So in this particular case, for this particular sub-image, I get the result as -3. Okay. And if I do it for all the points in my image, okay, this is what the result I get. Okay. Now, of course, you will see that some of the results are positive as well as some of the results are negative. And of course, they don't lie in the range of 0 to L minus 1. Okay. So this is my output of the Laplacian filter. I hope you must have understood the concept of filtering now. Now you can apply this concept for any filter that you have. Okay. Same process. Okay. Except for the order statistics, multiply it point by point, sum it up together and put it back where your center was lying. Thank you.